This mobile candy stall outside a Quezon City elementary school is one of the first stops made by students right after class. Business has been steady, but the stall owner is wary after government announced plans to tax junk food and other sweetened goods to address diabetes, obesity, and other diseases related to poor diet.
Mararamdaman rin ako pag ganun, halimbawa ganun, nasip rin yung kung gaano yung inaano ko dati, parang bababa na nga rin. Itong mga gamit ko, binibigay ko ng 7-10, kung mas lalong tumaas pa, kahit gawin ko na lang ganun, mga 6 ganun, para meron pa rin kahit konti.
The finance department says the proposed tax program plans to impose an additional 10 pesos per 100 grams or 10 pesos per 100 milliliters on prepackaged food which lack nutritional value. These include confectionaries, desserts, and snacks. They also plan to increase taxes on sweetened beverages at 12 pesos per liter under the train law. This tax scheme is expected to generate an additional 76 billion pesos during the first year of implementation. But additional government revenue isn't the only benefit from the proposal. That's according to Dr. Gerald Belandres.
Once nag-accumulate ang sugar, pwede din kasi ito ma-affect sa health nila, lalo na pag may mga history, family history na diabetes, no? And then syempre, yung mga diabetic patient din, mas mararegulate and makokontrol din nila yung pag-intake ng sugar.
He adds the measure can help discourage consumers from buying and binging on cheap but unhealthy snacks, which can lead to non-communicable diseases like heart disease, kidney disease, and stroke. It's also seen to reduce junk food consumption by 21%. The DOF says revenues from this will be used to fund socioeconomic programs and provide support to 1 million poor households. Rafael Bosano, ABS-CBN News.